What is the question that we've always hoped somebody would ask?
Steven?
No.
We've been touring together for 3 years now.
Chris Rock or Will Smith?
Chris Rock or Will Smith? Is this a fuck, marry, kill? All right? Are you asking me to choose between the guy who told a bad joke versus the guy who assaulted someone?
No, it's just the two black guys he knows.
Backstage, prepare for a show.
What do you normally do backstage? We can't tell them about the ritual.
Louis and I touch penises sometimes. I guess it's the sexiest thing. You've got to touch penises. He's looking over the edge. Like,
yeah,
I can survive that.
Bummer.
Would we do an ad lib battle right now? Okay. So an ad lib battle is it's a thing that Andrew and I have done on my YouTube channel, where we basically just take shots at each other. It's like a roasting of your friend, but it gets real fucking mean. Do you have a topic?
Yeah. Your career is like Sesame Street.
Your career is. I like your career. So your career is like Sesame Street.
It belongs in the garbage.
Yeah, I'm always up the ass.
I'm allergic to most of them.
I'm allergic to pussy. So
that's ridiculous. It's allergic to you.
Cat, put him down.
Favorite memory with my dad.
Strange flex, by the way. You're like, your dad's dead, mine's not.
Are you a nerdy person? If so, can you prove it?
I tutor SAT prep, ACT, chemistry, physics, math, and stuff. And I've actually got like a boss who works with me, and I had lunch with him just a couple days ago. And I was trying to, awkward boss conversation, I don't know what to say. So I said, hey, what excites you? And he's like, I'm boring. I watch nerdy YouTube videos. I was like, well, try me. He's like, well, I like Veritasium. I was like, I fucking love Veritasium. I was like, did you watch the video on complex numbers? He's like, did I? And we just had like a 30-minute conversation about nerdy-ass YouTube videos. Anyway, the Veritasium complex numbers, I promise you, that is 30 minutes of your life that you're really going to enjoy. This guy fucking gets it.
Yeah. I might not be a nerd. Holy hell, man. That is great.
This guy knows. Did you watch it or are you just joking around? Say again? Yeah, of course. Yeah. It was like, it's his opus. It's like the best video. It's so good. It's like equal parts.
Mark and Farrell, what are your opening acts? Which one is it?
Is there underwear for people with penises that don't have crotch holes?
Wait, why is there underwear for people with penises that don't have crotch holes?
Yes.
Because we're able to do that.
Here, let me show you.
So we were in the Liverpool airport during the...
Airport.
And what?
John Lennon Airport.
John Lennon Airport. Oh, yes. So thank you for the clarification. No one here had heard of it. So, now that everybody's on the same page. So we were in John Lennon Airport, the airport of Liverpool, which is north of here. It was the day of the funeral. The Queen died.
What do you think it means?
A local phrase, what is it?
Gertlash.
Gertlash. Gertlash? Gertlash. Gertlash. Oh, Gertlash. I thought Gertlash was when a Gert hits you from behind. Gertlash?
Gertlash. Gertlash is when you're so pissed drunk on the street and you just got anything that's gotta come out comes out.
Do you have a question?
No, not a question, but I wanted to give you something for Rosh Hashanah.
I appreciate that, but can you do that after the show? Because this is getting weird. Okay, thank you very much. That's okay. Thank you, I appreciate that, but I don't even like opening a gift in front of the person who gave it to me, let alone a fucking audience. So that would be very weird. There'd be a lot of pressure. Like, if it's good, that's awesome, but if it's weird, I have to be like, oh, thank you. And then I'm sure it's going to be wonderful, I'm sure. Thank you very much.
Did you have a gift for me? Because I do get gifts. That's a Steve thing. Yeah,
Steve,
Fred.
Do you have an empty cake box by any chance?
This is mine.
Belfast, the day of the funeral. And it was very, the whole thing was very surreal to us because we don't care. Someone's like, the Queen died, and I was like, Beyonce?
Just to circle back, because I know you guys don't understand like American lineages, but when Beyonce dies, Destiny's Child becomes the Queen.
As a New Yorker, what advice would you give to a straight white male salsa dancer who moved here from Texas to start law school 3 weeks ago?
That's cool. How long have you been salsa dancing?
4 years.
4 years?
Yeah,
very cool. You describe yourself as a salsa dancer,
yeah.
Not just someone who's like, oh, I think it's fun.
No,
do you do it professionally?
No, you can't
do it professionally? Okay, well, yeah. Then you're not good enough. Maybe. Yeah. Are you saying goodbye to salsa life forever?
No, I still do it 2-3 times a week.
Fuck yeah, man, that's what I like to hear. You want to be a lawyer, salsa?
Of course.
Nice.
I
in the courtroom, salsa?
Objection, he's leading the witness.
Thanks for following me on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, and now the Twitter sucks, Mastodon. I am touring all over the place. If you want to see if I'm coming to a city near you, check out stevehofstetter.com. And of course, watch videos like this before anybody else. Patreon.com/stevehofstetter.